again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.
I'll get your sweater from the car.
Sub-level 10, report.
Something's wrong with Sam. Dimensional breaches are occurring across the facility.
Secure your stuff. I'll have a Sam myself. Blanchard, secure the command post. Call in response teams. Get Liberty Falls locked down. Copy?
Copy.
What is up, everybody? It is Tog here. Welcome to Call of Duty Black Ops 6 Zombies. Before we jump into this game, I want to make a note that it is kind of cool that they don't make you jump straight into the game as they usually did in Black Ops 3 and before. I did play Black Ops 4. I played Black Ops 3 and I played Cold War, but I didn't play Cold War as intensely. If you don't know who I am, I'll get into that, but before we get started, it looks like we do play as the same players as Terminus. Based on the title, if you can infer, maybe you don't know what a cherry pop is, and that's okay. If you clicked on it anyway, this video might be a little bit more advanced, a little bit more mature, the topics and themes, so I just want to put that out there. If you're not used to what my videos entail, just putting that out there. But before we get started, I wanted to say this is the first time I'm recording on my Series X, which I purchased 2 days ago this past Friday for this game in particular. I got a game that I'm getting delivered tomorrow as well, so that'll be fun. That's probably what I'm going to use it mostly for, because I have plenty of things I still need to get done, but I wanted to get a good look at this game and enjoy it and give it a try. I'm going to give a quick talk about what I've done on this game, but first I want to show my Xbox and my PlayStation 4 real quick. And the reason I'm doing so is because I didn't trade in my Xbox like I had in the past. This Xbox, I bought and I traded in my old Xbox, which was the base Xbox One. It was just the regular one. And I, I named it Tiffany after, well, we'll say it's after Tiffany Harrison from Luckiest Girl Alive, but it's not. This one I named after Melissa Hastings from Pretty Little Liars, the original one. And I've got a good amount of time on them, and they're both going to be the main consoles I use. Well, for the most of the channels coming out, most of the series and episodes coming out on this channel. This will be just a standalone video as well that I felt driven, spiritually compelled to publish, we'll say. Yeah, I got a couple of things I want to talk about. The thing with upgrading your console is like the capabilities that it has, it is much faster and it has very good graphics, but my monitor can't reach that and neither can my recording device, so I'm sorry that this is not going to be at its peak. When I eventually do make videos with this device, I will hopefully have caught up. I will have hopefully accumulated wealth in many aspects of my life in some way and invested them into things that I want, which include this. So we'll see who we play as, if we're gonna be... Yeah, I wanted to show the cutscene and I wanted to go in and I'll talk about most of the things while I'm in there, but it looks like they're gonna want me to... It looks like they do make you watch it every time, so let's go ahead and get started. But we're gonna play as Maya, I think, unless there's other operators for this map. I played as the four of them in Terminus. I'm gonna be talking this entire time, so if you're not used to that, I'm sorry. But if you're just here to see some gameplay, no commentary, there's plenty of that on YouTube, I'm sure. And if you're looking at Easter egg stuff, I'm not doing that. This is purely just to give, just to record the first time I'm playing this map. I played four rounds of Terminus as the four characters because you're allowed to choose, and I didn't choose the first time, but Maya was the one I played as. And I'm honestly very impressed with this game and the characters and some of the stuff that I didn't like about Cold War. This is pretty much Cold War 2, the same way Black Ops 1 and Black Ops 2 followed it. This is Cold War 2. So I have no idea pretty much everything.
Liberty Falls. Population? Well, less than yesterday. Never been so glad to see backup arrive. Hell, I'm lucky I'm still in one piece. I need you to look for survivors, subdue any threats. Help me save this town. Copy.
We'll see if she has any dialogue options or if I... And let me real quick just make sure. I know I said I was gonna, but I gotta make sure that I'm not using the wrong operator, because in Terminus, the story-based mission involves these characters, and it says that there's dialogue specifically for that map that enhances the story, and that's something that they didn't have in Cold War that I like that they have here. And based on the four games that I've played, the zombies play really nicely. It's very enjoyable. It's honestly very fun. So let me just make sure. Yeah. So it looks like I will have exactly what I was looking for. So let's go ahead and skip that one more time. I'm expecting that this gameplay should last about at least 20 minutes because I have an understanding of the game and it is challenging, which I really, really like. I didn't feel like Cold War was challenging at all. And we'll see if the map here is as challenging. And I also like that they have two maps right out the gate without a paywall like they did in Black Ops 3. A paywall is just when you can't get through unless you pay. So that was the giant, basically. You had to get the season pass until later. Same thing with Black Ops 1. If you wanted the older World at War maps, you had to pay as well. So before I go on, I'm going to bring up, I like to talk about shows and movies and things that I'm reading and experiencing while I'm while I record, just because I think it's relevant sometimes. And I'm not turning off the voice volume like I did in Cold War.
Liberty Falls. Population? Well, less than yesterday. I need you to look for survivors. Subdue any threats. Help me save this town. Copy.
Yeah, and I thought this was going to be the secondary map, but they listed it first, so it must be somewhat relevant and important. But, yeah, so my Xbox is not, I don't think it's as perfect. And this seems to be the first time I'm playing this map, so I had troubles with this as well. For the gameplay aspect, it's gonna be a little iffy, alright?
We've got three scientists unaccounted for, last seen in town. Locating and extracting them is now your top priority.
I don't know how they expect me to get over there. Yeah, she doesn't seem to have too many dialogue options, but...
See? Can't be hungry if you don't have a head. Problem solved.
Alright, so I can't open some doors. So, there will be slight character spoilers, but no major plot stories for the most recent movie, The Batman, that came out in 2022. And after this, I'm planning to start watching The Penguin on HBO. And I'm planning to have one more video for certain about Black Ops 6, but I'll be uploading most of the other things at the same time regularly that I'm already planning, such as Old School Zombies and Far Cry 3, and some other videos in between that I may or may not have mentioned in series. You can check out the channel. I think I have it pretty listed out, and there are some videos that explain it more, and playlists that explain it more defined in that manner, so... This is mostly just going to be playing the game, talking about how I feel about it, and also talking about other relevant things in my life and the world in general, I think, based on the culture and plot and, I don't know, stuff that's going on. So if you haven't seen The Batman and you don't want to hear about it, I'm not going to spoil the main plot.
We need to find out what caused
but I will talk about some characters that you may know stuff about or may not want to hear about. So just be wary of that if you don't want to...
get lost. Etherella doesn't do autographs.
That's Dr. Moline. Joined the physics team last year. Nice enough guy, but weird.
So yeah.
Enough of your spooky bullshit. Nothing scarier than my right hook.
So this month of November, I do think there's value in having like seasons and things of that nature. So that's why I'm waiting. The next series I do with the Series X will be A Plague Tale: Requiem, and that'll be in the second half of 2027. So that's a pretty long time from now. Or is it 2028? No, second half of 2027. So I won't be using this for a good amount of time. This will be the only video on the channel with it, and hopefully I can understand everything better and get it, but it's just, there's just a lot on my plate, but I wanted to get this now, and then while I get the, hopefully, fork software and, like, recording systems and stuff that I want to, like, continue advancing my channel, I'll worry about that, plus, like, other life stuff that takes higher priority right now. But today is the 27th of October, which is a Sunday. I don't usually record on Sundays because I try to make sure it's a rest day, but in honor of the fact that this is kind of like a new beginning for my channel, I will probably use this as the main recording device once I'm done with all the other series that I've mentioned. I just thought it was fitting that the first video I have uploaded currently, it wasn't the first video I made, but the first video that I've kept up was also recorded on February 14th of 2021, which is also a Sunday. If you haven't guessed, the reason I don't record on Sundays is religious. Like, I just try to make it a day of rest.
Don't suppose Uncle Sam gives out medals for marksmanship. Couldn't settle for a biggie.
To prioritize my rest and to prioritize giving a day to, like, not be distracted by all the busyness of life.
Wish you warned me about splash zones, Peck? Would have packed a poncho.
I don't need a gun. I can probably make it a little further with just the melee. It's pretty good, and I held B, which is, I play it with tactical, so that's how I pulled out the melee. But I may lose my train of thought pretty regularly, because I'm going to be playing at the same time, but this is kind of just like to give added noise to the gameplay while also talking. The reason I made this channel was because I want to be able to continue having video games in my life. I think video games is my first love, and I think it might be honestly a gift of mine. One of the gifts that I think I was given that I could really make something out of. I can't know for sure unless I try, so this is to me trying, and I feel like I have been supported with that, spiritually and physically, I suppose. Sheesh, I gotta be careful. I don't really expect those lag things to like get me killed, but this is like kind of what I'm talking about, this training, the amount of zombies and the strength of it, the challenge that's been picked up. I'm very satisfied with it. I'm happy the way they made it, but I gotta keep progressing in the right direction. I need to make sure I'm watching my essence and my salvage. And I don't, yeah, I need a little bit more here. I really enjoy that they, so.
Pickers, mouthy shits like you never know when to quit. Are you related to Peck?
They fucking hate Peck for, like, no reason. I don't know. I actually don't know the story, so maybe they hate him for a good reason. But that's something I've noticed, that I usually don't like humor at the expense of another person. I do think they have some good lines and some good things that is much improved. That was one of the better things of the original crew, is that they were all pretty funny and they had their own personality. Like I said, I played one game with each of them, so I know them pretty decently, and the first one I played as was this girl, Maya.
Someone go grab a mop and a bucket. We got a gusher.
And I think she reminds me the most of Takeo, and in my old school zombies, I'm going to be playing most of my games as Takeo. I didn't have choice in that, it's just how it ended up, and also I played the Zetsubou no Shima Easter egg earlier, and it's under the title Fall 24 Look Ahead. It was originally under the title of Seeds of Doubt, Zetsubou no Shima. The thing is, the reason I made that video wasn't to showcase that Easter egg, it was to showcase the types of videos in the videos that I was putting out later this year, but I also wanted to showcase that. So that's the reason I made this channel was because I wanted to be able to play video games regularly without it taking up a lot of my time. Because these games now, you can see they're marketed to a younger generation because kids, teenagers, they tend to have more time to play video games than adults do. But I really want to make sure that adults, like older people who like have jobs or are studying or things like that, have time to like have video games but may not have enough time to play them. Or play them but not as much, or just a little bit of both, honestly. That's
be safe.
That's the audience I have in mind when I'm making these videos, and it seems that's what's ended up happening. I like most of my audience is above 18 and under like 40, which I think is like.
You see the face on that thing? Nightmare fuel.
A youthful group that isn't quite under. I think eventually, since this game is pretty popular with the younger generation, I think its main competitor is Fortnite, and I just think that for a couple of reasons, but it's definitely competing with it in my opportunity cost, at least, because I'm probably not going to get the season pass for Fortnite because I want to play a little bit more games like this. And I know I'm sweating. I'm wearing this Yankees jacket that I have, and it's just because they're currently competing in the World Series, and it's a bit of an ancestral thing for me, so I'm hoping that they can improve after these two away losses. The first game was pretty brutal, and I would love to touch on that again, but before I get too far into it, I want to talk about why I named this video the way I did, the Liberty Falls Cherry Pop. Popping your cherry is slang for losing your virginity, and that's like where I'm talking, like this may be a little bit of an uncomfortable topic if you're not super comfortable talking about sex, and why I'm saying it's a more mature topic. But if you are under 18 or anything like that and you're watching this video, either your parents let you play rated M games, they don't let you play rated M games, but they don't monitor your internet history and stuff, or you don't care that it's deep like that, or you're just curious. I use this channel also to kind of speak on topics that I think are important while also driving them by what I'm driven to speak about, like, and I feel like I'm called to speak about it as well, because although I think that one of my gifts is being like talented in my ability in the video game department, I also think I have a very good speaking voice and a very good presentation aspect, and that can be applied in careers, but this is a career that I think I could apply that to, and that I would enjoy applying it to, and that I would like to work at and hopefully be able to do. I mean, I already do it pretty consistently, but more often. We'll see how that goes, but the way I want to connect it to my personal life is that I'm not a virgin, but I feel but I'm not really here to talk about me. I'm here to talk about the two virginities in my life that I have taken, and I'm not going to address them, but they were in high school when I was when I first got my other Xbox, and they were both consensual acts, and they were both different acts, and they were enjoyable and nice. But I use the word take as in took.
Yeah. Ventilating you shits never gets old.
Because I feel as though it's not about that. It's more, I do think it was a stealing because I'm not marrying either one of them, and I did not marry either one of them. And that is a very old-fashioned ideology that you shouldn't have sex until you're married, but it does have some biblical context, and I do read a lot of that and see the merit that it has. And I didn't really believe or really think that I should stop having sex or anything of that nature.
No. Dr. Pelletier, my favorite egghead. Not just book smart, but street smart.
Outside of wedlock until well after I went on my journey. And the main reason I fell away from my faith when I was in high school and middle school is because I wanted to have sex. And this isn't me trying to tell you what you should or shouldn't do. It's me trying to educate you more about, like, about religion and sex and things of that nature, because I think sometimes we don't always have access to that. It's a very taboo topic. People don't like speaking about it. People are concerned. It makes people uncomfortable. I wouldn't be surprised if it makes you a little uncomfortable. Sometimes it's not super easy for me to do either, but I think it's important. I think I should do it. I think I'm supposed to do it, so I hope that's okay with you. But if you don't want to hear anymore, that's okay. Feel free to click off the video. But just so you know, my Fortnite video is going to touch on that topic a lot, so just be prepared for that if you are planning to watch that one at the end of this month. Okay, so the date in question is also the holiday is All Saints Day, and it's a Catholic holiday. It's just something to honor the people who have reached sainthood, but I want to emphasize that all the people who have been saints or became saints were all sinners at one point. That is like just something that is understood, but maybe not always understood. We all think that we have to be perfect if we want to, like, get into a heaven if we believe in that. Then that's why it's easier to just not believe.
The hell out of shooting lawn gnomes with an air rifle.
In a hell or a heaven, because then we would have to abide by those rules. But life is a little bit longer than we give it credit for, and I do not believe that having sex before marriage sends you to hell or anything like that. I'm not gonna pretend that I'm a judge. Like, I don't know that. I think that would be out on a deathbed. Like, that gets figured out. But for me personally, I think it matters how you finish and not how you start. But how you start affects how you finish. And what I mean by that is that we all have different temptations. We all have different things that drive us to commit acts that are bad, whether it be like stealing or whether it be like cheating or whether it be lying. Maybe lying to an extent where you're like trying to hurt somebody. Like, because I don't necessarily think lying is a sin unless you're using it to deceive or you're trying to say that someone did something that they didn't. And that would be with bearing false witnesses, which is one of the Ten Commandments. But yeah, so I just wanted to address that that is something that I have done and that something that I want to not revisit, but like admit that I did. And that even though it was like something that seemed okay at the time, like that maybe that may affect them in ways that I can never know, because that sticks with you for a long time. Like even me. A lot of people want to do that in high school and college and they don't think much of it, but that act can really hurt a lot of people and how you see yourself and how you go on in the future. I just think that it's okay to address that I don't think that it's really right to do that anymore. And it took me a really long time to come to that conclusion, but that's just how I feel. And you don't have to agree with me, you can just enjoy the zombies. But while I'm on that topic, I did mention that I was going to talk about Batman a little bit, and it's because I've spoken about Spider-Man in my first Fortnite video, and I want to speak about Batman a little bit in this video, because I think the Arkham series might be a game that I explore in the future on this channel. And based on what the movie that I saw, I've seen some of the Dark Knight movies, but they didn't draw me as much. And I'm seeing this reboot, which is basically when a series starts over from the beginning with new characters, new actors. Pretty Little Liars is an example of that, but also the Spider-Man movies and the Batman series are other examples of that. So I think this Call of Duty Black Ops is kind of experiencing that in a way that's similar, because they still sometimes talk about the older characters like Richtofen we saw in that cutscene. Sheesh. But we also have new characters and a new way to play, but we have even some old perks like PhD Flopper finally making a return, but it's not as good. I already tried it out. You know, and it's just different, but there's different doesn't always mean better. It doesn't always mean worse. It just means different. And I think that my
get the splattering you slop all over my good boots.
I think the older games still have a lot of value and merit, so that's why I want to make sure that they're still on YouTube somewhere being played now. And I know that plenty of people are going to be playing this game regularly. Like, I don't feel like I need to do that. I don't think that I necessarily need to compete with other YouTubers for your views. I want you to enjoy what you enjoy, and if that aligns with what I put up, that makes me happy. I'm happy for you, but I want you to spend your time the way you feel most comfortable spending it. Go wherever it is that you need to go, and I'll be okay. I think that's true love personally. But I did want to see this game, and I wanted to make my own opinions of it, and yeah, so I do enjoy it. I think it's challenging. I think this is going to be a successful game, and it learned a lot based on what Cold War was and how to make it a little better. I definitely think this game has improved on some of the things that Cold War did wrong. One of the things that I didn't like about Cold War,
that's the sound of your fart,
was the characters not being attached to the map. So these four, I don't know if they're that attached to this one. They're definitely more attached to Terminus and the storyline there. I don't know much about this map at all. I definitely really liked Terminus. I thought it was fun. But the other characters, in the order that I played them, this one was the first one. I made it to round 17 and then I died. The second time I played it,
some things never change.
I played as Dr. Gray, and I think she's the most, if I didn't mention this earlier, I think
whatever the hell just popped out of that corpse.
Alright, so I don't know if I mentioned this, but I think that Maya reminds me the most of Takeo because she's very purpose-driven, and she's very light. Like, Takeo is described as being, like, smaller, so. Then I play as Dr. Gray, and she reminds me the most of Nikolai. It is a little bit because of her build, but she's also more crass, which is just, like, you're a little bit more vulgar, and you're a little bit less
boy.
Proper, I suppose. I liked her too. They were all pretty funny. And Weaver, I think, is the most like Richtofen because he's very clever and analytical. He has his funny moments as well.
How about you get off your ass and give it a go?
And I thought that was cool. And then Carver is last. I got to round 14 with Gray, and I got to 12 with Weaver. So I actually decreased my ability, my like performance, I guess you could call it. But I was looking around, I was experiencing, and I was learning, so whatever. And then Carver, I think, is the most like Tank Dempsey, and most of it was because of his quotes. But he also seems to be like the strongest, like the way he talks. He seems like the most like Tank Dempsey, in my opinion. He also seems like to the point. So I really like the characters. I'm curious to see how they progress with it, but I like there's only four just to continue on like that. Even if there were, it's just as many as it can handle. So I like that a lot. And then with Carver, I X-filled on round 11 because I wanted a calling card that I don't seem to have, which is really annoying. I thought I had it, but it didn't save. It's kind of annoying. I'll show it after this game because I worked hard to unlock it, but is what it is. But I did think that Cold War was a little bit less fun than old school zombies per se, like Black Ops 1, Black Ops 2, even up to Black Ops 3 at a certain point. Shit, this might be a little tougher. And the reason I liked Black Ops 1 and Black Ops 2 so much was because you could just jump into a game, kill zombies, let loose, blow off steam, and then move on with your day. Black Ops 3, I think, started to make it so that you could survive for a very long period of time with double pack-a-punch because it was infinite damage, and also the three hit down and things like that. It actually did become harder because the zombies were faster, so I understand what they did, but the double pack-a-punch just made it really repetitive.
Seriously? What are you trying to prove with that aluminium arm wang of yours?
And also with Black Ops 3, I found that the maps were not very fun unless you knew what you were doing. You knew what the map was, and that started kind of with Origins. And I don't feel that way with this map. I don't feel that, I don't know about this map, but, well, I don't because I'm playing it right now. But with Terminus, like, I didn't know a lot of the extra stuff. Maybe in the future I will look it up. Like, that's what, the fuck? Oh, I haven't done one of those yet. We'll see. I might want to get perks and stuff first. But I really like, oh shit. I really like that I can just hop into a game and kill zombies. And I think this save and quit thing is a, when there is no active exfil.
You nerds see that? I'm just warming up, baby.
I think that
exfil is no longer available.
I think the save and quit is a solo player's dream. And I do play a lot of solo because most people like just don't like playing as much zombies as I do, which I get. And I also just like, I really like to just, it's peaceful for me to be able to just like kill zombies and shred. I do talk a little bit more now, like I commentate, but I don't always need to commentate. Like I like playing without commentary too, but I have enough to talk about this time. And oh my god, I love the combat axe in this game because you can go through people. It's fucking sick. Sheesh. The zombie designs are cool as well. I think there were some interesting design choices there. But the save and quit is kind of cool because these games can go on for a very long time, and that helps the grind set. Like, if you want to go for a very long time, that's cool. Whereas with Black Ops 1, Black Ops 2, you either had to pause it and leave your Xbox on, which is, like, pretty bad for energy. And, or your PS4 or your PlayStation.
Turn them to pieces.
I don't like this announcer that much. I wish it was still Samantha, but there's reasons for why that is no longer the case. But it does seem like she still has some involvement based on that cutscene, because that was who Richtofen was talking to. Like, they still fucking have a rivalry, which I fucking dig. I think that's fucking sick. Also, the movement. I wasn't sure if I was gonna buy Black Ops 6, but after playing the beta, which was just the multiplayer, I love this movement. The fact that you can sprint in 360 directions, that you can dolphin dive, or you can slide, or you can just crouch. But yeah, I definitely really, it seems very skill based. Like you have to be very deliberate in your actions, which is something that I very much enjoy when video games do, because it allows you to be more skilled. It allows more opportunity for skill. So
whoops, where'd your head go?
In July is when I plan on posting another Black Ops 6 video, and it will be multiplayer. I'm planning to play a lot of multiplayer for this game, like in my free time, and see what I have to feel about it, and then post some multiplayer, because I love playing Call of Duty multiplayer. The only thing is you just like have to really pick the right one, because some of these Call of Duties like aren't as good as other ones, and I'm grateful that they have experience to learn from all of them, and they have an audience that will purchase them, but I make sure to pick and choose my Call of Duties now, because there's a lot of other games that I would rather play. When you're younger, you have less choice in how many games you can play. Like, you probably only get to play like one or two that you're allowed to like spend your parents' money on. But as you get older and you have your own money, you can choose how much to invest. But that's where I go back to talking about opportunity cost. What you spend on one thing, you can't spend on something else. So if you only have so much money, it goes a certain way. I think the Series X in this game was worth the purchase, but I know that it's like a long-term investment. I'll probably be playing it in the future. I wonder if I can open this door or not. I'm really, really enjoying this game so far, but it's not going to be the game I'm playing all the time now. It'll be a game that I visit in the future again, and I'm curious to hear about what people think about it and how people enjoy it while I'm still playing the older games and experiencing what I can there. There's a lot I want to do on this channel, and I'm glad that I can squeeze this in.
Make room, you rotted sausages. I'm coming through.
But it's not going to be my priority. I don't think I mentioned this, that this was what I was going to upload, so I hope it was a pleasant surprise if you wanted to watch something like this. Hear my thoughts on it, but yeah, it's gonna be like a standalone thing as well. But I kind of like the idea of the specials because I think it is valuable to treat days special, like I said about the Sunday where I don't do work. I think treating holidays differently is a similar thing where you do something special for them. So All Saints Day isn't a holiday that many people know. They maybe call it Dia de los Muertos in Mexico. I think it's the 1st of November. I don't know that much, but I might be accurate there.
Busting heads for fun and profit, and business is booming.
In my culture, it's All Saints Day, which I really like, and I know I did a lot for Halloween yesterday. I think it's good to learn about both and experience both sides of the, I don't even know what to call it, the world, because there is that everywhere, and you choose your side, and it's just how it is. I don't know. There's times for everything. I do think it would be good for me to start getting perks. That's another thing I think this map seems like it's slightly easier than Terminus now that I'm seeing it. So that must be why they listed it first, because this was more of learning and the other one's more for like really like grinding. Like, and that map was good. That map was really good. I really liked it because there's so much to it, but it's not so spacious. Like, this is pretty spacious. I could see why this would be pretty easy, and that's fine. But I definitely think the other map is a little bit better. Oh shit. But I just love this, the hoarding like this, like the way they run like this. Like it definitely does have the same aspect that the older Call of Duties did. And also the mini-map, there's this now too. Well, I guess it's cool, although I still don't know where Jug is. I think I just saw it though. Let me see if I can find it. I think it's in this direction. Yep. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get through here, but... Jug is not very necessary in this game, which is something I think they wanted to start with Black Ops 4 by not even including it at all. Oh fuck, this looks dangerous as fuck. Wow, but this looks beautiful. I wonder what this is, a bank? Yeah, it's a bank. Oh fuck. Oh, I gotta get out of this. Yeah, this is cool, this is cool. You don't need it. You don't need it at all. But it's nice to have. But Pack-a-Punch is pretty expensive, you have to be pretty choice. And there's no high-grade and low-grade salvage anymore. There used to be high-grade and low-grade and it would depend. I'm so glad they made it just salvage because that was something oh fuck, that might have gotten me fucking killed. Now we're good. That I liked about Black Ops 1, playing it when I was younger, is I really got to learn how to manage my money at a young age. Like, I know it's not real money, but since you only get one life, it's survival based.
Max armor.
You have to be choicey about how you spend your money. If you spend money here, you can't spend it there. If you go down, you can't. You need to account for it. If you go down, you need to buy your perks again. So here, I've seen that you have to be very wary about either you focus on your weapons mostly, or you focus on your gun. That's what your essence is. That's the same thing. Or you focus on your perks, and I think it's pretty enjoyable as well. Or it seems like armor. Let's do it. I've never bought this before, so I'm gonna try to buy armor and see how it goes. It's pretty pricey. I like how they did it. And I also like how they did this gobblegum machine too. It's really fucking awesome.
Just got my sea legs.
You don't have to eat the gobblegum right away. You can grab it and hold on to it and activate it when you need it. I like how they did gobblegum. It looks amazing. And I'll show the menu after this game, and maybe we'll be able to hear the zombies music. I think we heard it a little bit at the beginning, and that was pretty cool as well. But I'm gonna go until I die. I'm not gonna exfil or anything. That's just how I like to play zombies. I'd really, really enjoy that, but I think it's great that exfil is an option because it kind of allows you to do what I was saying, where you just hop in a game, kill some zombies, and get out. You don't have to go down, which is something that you used to have to. I've never seen this before, but that looks familiar. Oh, shit. How the fuck am I supposed to kill this thing? Holy crap. Sheesh. Well, let's go ahead and pop this gobblegum then.
Listen, fuckers. Efficiency is key when running a business.
This is me being efficient.
Oh, fuck. Shit. I think that did damage, but I can't be certain. I'm also hoping that healing aura isn't overpowered, because in Cold War it was so overpowered.
Got a one-way ticket back to base with your name on it.
God damn! I'm gonna go pack a punch again. Assuming that I don't die on the way there. I like that there's a back entrance as well. Well, they say only thieves going through the back entrance.
You know your prices are a bit steep, but I think you're right. Ta.
Fucking die, yo. I kind of do enjoy figuring things out on my own, but it's very difficult to do. There we go. That's beautiful.
Gonna tell me about the three-headed meat grinder?
I just felt like with some maps, you just can't freaking like learn it as you play it. You have to go online. At least if you want to do the Easter egg stuff, I still think that's going to be the case here. Whatever, maybe that's okay. Because in Cold War, they kind of seem... I kind of didn't like that they forced it on you, like the main quest, like always telling you. So I can't have the best of both. I didn't mind looking it up and having a community and all that. And I think a lot of people in Zombies love it, but I think that they're finding a happy medium. I am really approving how this game is ending up. I like that there's no Wonder Fizz, although I do kind of want to see... I don't think they have Elemental Pop on this map, huh? I do really enjoy that perk. They have Melee Macchiato, which is cool. Like, you just get to fucking have a strong melee. Maybe I'll get it later depending on how this game goes, but it doesn't seem too bad. Like I said, it seems a little bit easier. You must stop her. I wonder who her is. Look at this Collat. It's fucking awesome. Oh, this is cool, and it's so much bigger, which
got plenty more where that came from.
Seems realistic, but it's cool. You can also mantle things, whereas in Black Ops 1 and Black Ops 2, you would get fucking murdered if you got stuck against something. Like here, I'd be trapped, and they did it intentionally. So that also makes the game a little easier, but I'm definitely liking that I'm getting to experience it, and I think it's good that I'm experiencing it now when it's so new. Just, I don't know. Just in case anyone wants their first experience watching this game to be with me. And if it is, I'm honored. And if it's not the first time you're seeing this game, well, hopefully I can show you something that the other instance that you saw, I can't. Whether it be by yourself or with another channel. I definitely encourage playing games yourself. And that's why a lot of people will say, like, who's gonna, like... watch a YouTube video of a game when they can just play it themselves. And some people like prefer watching over playing, or there's some games that you would rather watch than play. I feel that way with certain games. Maybe I'll get into that one day, but I don't know if we need to talk about that right now. There's so much talking and stuff. The reason I mentioned Batman is because I've spoken about Spider-Man, and I'm like trying to like learn more about Spider-Man. I'll talk about him more in the future, but we're focusing on Batman now. I just think that Batman, at least from what I've experienced, is a bachelor. He is not romantic.
Honestly,
at all.
It's not a bad makeover. I think you look great.
Where Spider-Man always had romantic aspects to the movies and stuff, whereas Batman is just so serious and dark, but it's like very interesting. It seems almost to an extent a little bit more grown. So I thought that was interesting watching that, and I'm curious to see how the Penguin advances on that. I'll probably talk about the Penguin in that multiplayer video that I make, but I just think that video games have become more commonplace now, and that's why the villain in the Batman was the Riddler rather than the Joker that most people are familiar with, just because the Riddler was made very popular from those Arkham games because of the Riddler trophies and things like that. I haven't played them, but I have seen them a little bit, and I think I would want to start them from the beginning, and I would probably try to play them over the course of like 15 years. I think youth probably goes until like a little bit past 40. After that, it's more like middle age, and it gets like more difficult to do things that youthful people are better at doing. But you can still have plenty of value when you're in that age. It just, you might have to adapt and show it in different ways. Like, wow, that's cool. But I really like this the way they're doing radios now, and you can see them. I'll show everything in the menus after this. You don't have to reload anymore either. They really mean max when they mean max. But I like the way they've done a lot of things, and I appreciate where they started from, and I feel like they pay a lot of homage to the original games, which I appreciate since I played them. But I also think it's great introducing people to these games, and something I didn't like is that they, like, it seemed kind of like they wanted you to play forever when, oh my god. And I don't really like that. I think there should be a way to, like, die. One of the biggest complaints I had about Black Ops 4, for example, was the difficulty setting. And that they, like, all the maps, like, seemed pretty much the same. And you could make it harder based on your choice. Whereas in Black Ops 1 and Black Ops 2, the maps themselves were more difficult as it went on. Shangri-La and Moon were substantially
many bloody times
harder than... Sheesh, they're quick. Kino der Toten. Not 5, and Ascension. Call of the Dead was a medium map, probably, but I really like that they expanded that a little bit, and it seems like they did that here, where this map is easier, much easier than Terminus, but I would definitely probably play... Oh my god, I may have gone the wrong fucking way. Like, I went so far with Cold Wars to try to make the game more difficult by staying in a certain spot the whole game. And it was pretty fun. Like, I made some videos you can find on my archives about that. But I didn't want to force the game to be so easy. Because even in the later maps, like, all the maps were so easy. They were all, like, really easy. It was kind of upsetting to me. Moving forward on the Black Ops 3, right now, I'm finally getting to appreciate Gorod Krovi. Because maybe it was, like, during that time when it came out in 2015. I was a sophomore in high school. And I had just moved to a new place, and I was just like, I didn't have as much time to, like, learn the maps and everything, so it was, like, really upsetting to me, because, like, the maps were supposedly good, but, like, I couldn't just hop in and play them. I would have to, like, spend, like, so much time on YouTube, like, fucking learning them, or I was never gonna be able to play it. It had its drawbacks, but here, like, the fact that the Wonder Weapons are in the box again... Fucking fuck yeah. I mean, not that I know the Easter egg steps, maybe that's not the case for all of them. Fuck, I gotta deal with this. I like that they just call it an elite instead of an abomination, because I think that's like that is an overly biblical use term that I think can be taken out of context a lot of times. So sometimes, like, when they use words like that, like even disciple they used in Forsaken as well. I just think that you have to be very delicate about how you address those topics, because if you're not educated or people aren't educated about them, they might take it the wrong way. So that's why I try to find a middle ground and try to speak about it the best way I can. But it's difficult, like, tackling topics like this. Sometimes it's easier to just...
You lucky undead bastard.
Sometimes it's easier to just not broach on topics like that at all, like the more difficult ones, because you can reach a broader or a more wide audience that way. But then your authenticity and your enjoyment disappears, because you're not challenging yourself, you're not pushing anything, you're not making anyone think. You're just like, sorry to throw you under the bus, the Smith plays, but like, top 10, like, I don't know. And you were an inspiration to me, so don't get me wrong. But, like, I just feel like I understand why you may have lost your love for making YouTube. I just think it was something that I noticed. If you're matching the crowd instead of matching what you really like. And maybe you did really like Fortnite, and I wouldn't blame you for that. But based on when you started streaming a little bit, when you got back, like, it was zombies. So I think your love was always there, but... You got a little caught up in the numbers and stuff, and I think it killed your love for it. Just an observation, but this is getting a little challenging. I like that the elite zombies aren't excessive, but that they're there and that they take hits to kill. Holy shit. But yeah, I did complete Zetsubo no Shima and Derizon Drock solo. Those are both on my channel. I'll eventually put them in a playlist so that they're easier to find, but since there's not that much on my channel right now recently, you should be able to find them if you want to watch them. They're very long videos, but I'm trying to, like, make them a little better. Gorod Krovi I'm working on right now. That'll come out in the springtime, so I'll get more information on that later. There's plenty of them in the meantime, and I have to, like, figure it out. It's very difficult, but I like those challenges now that I'm getting around to learning them and having the time. I'm really glad that those games are still alive and that I can make time to play them, that I can... make time to finally learn them. It just wasn't time for me to experience them when I was younger. Like, this is the time I feel like I'm more mature, I'm more driven, I'm more disciplined, which those maps require. Whereas, like, maybe at the beginning, like, Kino and stuff, like, didn't. Moon and Shangri-La definitely did, but I had a lot of time. Like, that was, like, what I did. I was, like, I think in, like, late elementary school, early middle, so like it was kind of what I was interested in. Like I didn't
too much going on up there anyway.
Like people will say like, yeah, like the opposite sex probably. It's true. Like once you get up there, you want to experiment, you want to figure it out. So like I definitely spent a lot of my time doing that. But now that I've like admittedly had those experiences and I understand what they are and how they affect people and how they affect me as well, I realize that like I'm willing to wait until the right person comes along. So I'm not telling you to do whatever or anything, but just something to think about. Where's this fucking box, by the way? The box in this game is also done exceptionally well. I guess I should finish that thought. Do what you think is best, do what you feel is best, but like understand that you can make mistakes and still end up a saint. Whatever you consider to be a mistake, this is beautiful. Holy crap. Oh yes, that is even more beautiful. Please buy it.
Anyone else want to run through a brick wall with me?
God damn. I could buy ammo. I think it is a little bit pricier. That was something that cool they did. You can't buy ammo at the wall, but you can buy ammo for every gun now. Yeah, this is tough. That was pretty badly thrown. You also have to unlock a lot of things like the craftables, which I wasn't sure how I felt, but I guess it is cool to work towards something instead of being able to get everything right at the bat. So I kind of like this gun a lot, and it's got a good rarity on it. I need to like... Shoot. Let's go pack-a-punch it though. What is this called, by the way? The Xenon Matter Granulator. The XM... Oh, I have two XM4s. Is this an XM4? I think this is also an XM4. Well, I guess I'll replace the other one. And this is the thing about Pack-a-Punch 2. They made it more, you can just do this and leave. You don't have to, like, wait for it to get out. Oh, fuck, this is bad.
Take it from a smuggler who knows. Heads are basically pineapples filled with jam.
Cool. Apparently a smuggler knows what a pineapple filled with jam is. That's cool. Sir Davos vibes. But yeah, so I definitely like what they did with the characters. I definitely like what they did with the game. I always really liked the fact that you could buy more perks now. They just get more expensive with each successive one that you buy, so you have to sacrifice. It's the opportunity cost makes you make choices. That's always really enjoyable and fun. Fully repair costs 5,000. That could be worth it, but I still have armor. I might just lose some eventually. I'm glad that it fills up extra. It fills up exactly how much it needs. But yeah, the game that I'm gonna play my Series X on. Like, the thing is, this monitor can't reach 4K, but I do have a TV in a living room that has 4K, so I'm probably just gonna leave it there and play Sonic X Generations, because when I got my first Xbox, the first game I played on it when I was younger was Sonic the Hedgehog, and I really liked that game, and I'm sad that they don't include Silver anymore, like, anywhere, but Shadow and Sonic were really cool to learn about and play, and I've played other of his games in the past, but I think I can play that one more for fun, like maybe on Sundays or something, whereas this game I'll play when I'm ready to record it, and I have other things to record that I can record on Tiffany. Oh, by the way, I named this Series X Britney after Britney Spears, because when I was picking it up, the song that was playing was Oops, I Did It Again. When I got there, the song that was playing was Hot and Cold by Katy Perry, but me and Katy, we go way back, so like, I don't think it would be fitting to name my Series X after her. But Britney Spears, I could relate to that, so I think we'll get together later on, but for now I think Tiffany still has a lot of life she needs to live first, and we have a lot of work to do as well. And we'll get around to Melissa as well. I'm giving her a bit of time. I just watched shows on her. I like to name a lot of my devices. I know that may sound strange to you, but to me it allows me to give them a soul, which makes them less replaceable. You know, like that first Xbox that I replaced, I didn't have a name, and it was pretty easy to replace, and I almost like forget a lot about it, but it was more difficult for me to replace this one, because like we have a history, and she has a name. So like, I think I can hold on to both, and then when the time comes, I can be really upset. It does hurt to lose, I named one of my basketballs Barry, after the pixel in Super Paper Mario, and that, I was really, really sad giving that up. I had to get a new one. I named the new one Jimmy, after Jimmy Butler. He had a good season, it was pretty cool.
Well, that's just good, clean fun, isn't it?
And yeah, so it's cool. Basketball season's right now as well, so there's a lot going on, but I am wearing the baseball just to celebrate. I'm not as much of a baseball fan as I am a Yankees fan, whereas with basketball, I'm a Hawks fan, but I'm also a basketball fan. Like, I watch basketball for fun. I wouldn't really watch baseball if it wasn't really the Yankees. What the fuck? Oh, shit. That's cool. That's definitely some Easter egg stuff. Yeah, I can't buy ammo there. I don't have that. Let me see if there's somewhere I can buy more armor, I guess. I don't know. I think I should save my points to get a different gun. I still have not found this freaking box. I only got, like, the ray gun in Cold War, like, once. It's very difficult to get wonder weapons, and that's why I think they instilled the... They have, like, a gobble gum now. How the fuck do I get over there? They have a gobble gum now that lets you get a wonder weapon for sure next time you hit the box. And it looks like there's a few. So that's pretty cool. I think that's a really cool ad. I'm, like, really impressed with what they've done with this game.
Poppin' smoke!
Ay-yay-yay. Alright, let's see if I can find this fucking box. It is keeping its distance. Oh, it might be it's in the bowling alley. It's probably gonna be a little challenging, too, considering I don't have armor. Is this a elemental pop? No, I can't even get back there. There it is. I like it. Okay, so what I was... Shit. See, I like that depending on the round. What the fuck? Did I pick up ammo? Oh, well.
For me? Really? What's the catch? Sorry, what's the habit?
That's a good question to ask when you're getting a deal that looks too good to be true. And if you can't find it, maybe you will after the fact. But yeah, as you can see, you can do all this stuff, but you can't really... Let me see how much... I have a lot of salvage, so I could upgrade some of my guns. Shit. I could upgrade some of my guns, rarity, but I don't know if I can do that here. Nah, I can only, yeah. So I have to find an armor station. And I think I'm gonna drink some Quick Revive as well. Yo, I'm like it always glitches for some reason. It's kind
of
annoying.
I'll help all you sons of bitches.
Bruh.
And the goodness of my damn heart even. Good.
I lost my train of thought. I don't know. I was talking a little bit about sports. But yeah, I like the gobblegums don't cost anything too. It makes you more incentivized to use them in that it's only the amount, less about points. I think it tells you again where they are when you drink, when you eat them. Nah, it doesn't tell you. It tells you when you pick it up, not after.
You need to hit the exit button. We're ready.
I definitely want to get the rarity upgrade. I think it's cool if there's a couple of ways to do that where the rarity is with your salvage and the crafting is with your salvage, but the points are with your weapon and your perks. I mentioned that before. Guillotine. But yeah, I probably won't buy a self-revive just to make sure I don't last too long, because I do want to die at some point. I don't really want to go forever. And I mean, the X-Fail could. I mean, did I eat this? Yeah, it's active. Looks like it doesn't run out like some of the other ones do. There's also less variety with gobblegums, which I actually think is a good thing. Because it gives you... It's not so overwhelming when you have so much there to think about and look at. Dang, that Harley Quinn look-alike though. But yeah, another game that I'm thinking of trying out is Tomb Raider. I've played the first two games in their entirety, but I would love to try... I would love to try to do them for my channel. I think I'm capable of doing so. But that won't be until maybe also like 25 to 2040. Like I think those are two trilogies of games that I would like to, even if they do make new games for it or reboot them in the future. It does seem like those three were the series, like Arkham Origin. No. It was Arkham Asylum, Arkham City, and Arkham Knight I would want to play. I'm dead. Fuck! I almost made it too. Alright, let's wait a little bit longer. Alright, I said I wasn't gonna get a self-revive, but considering I don't have that much salvage, and there is a limit in this game, there was no limit in Cold War. I might try and do that. Because now I'm like, now I realize I do want to survive. Maybe I am having fun after all. Let's see if I can do this.
Exfil helos needed elsewhere.
I see it. There's just that is a little bit overwhelming. It was a little easier in Cold War because you could just go left and right. I think maybe later on they added so many that you also had to do that. But to have to do this in the middle of the game is challenging as fuck.
Heads are basically pineapples filled with jam.
This is good. This is good. I'm liking this. I'm actively being challenged. I'm feeling a little nervous. So like I like that feeling. Like that's what I seek when I'm playing these games. But they are like not giving me that many drops even. So I'm gonna see what I can do with the points department here. I could probably use Speed Cola, but it wouldn't be a good purchase right now, because then I'd be broke. See, I've, like, used my money. I can't even Pack Punch, really. I probably could Pack Punch. That might be my next purchase. Jug is definitely helpful right now. Holy crap. Let's see. This is going to have to be done very quickly and very efficiently. There we go. So now I have one get out of jail free card, and it didn't cost me any points. Which means I can try and pack a punch this gun right here with 5,000. There is a slight difference in how the essence, the points. I'm gonna try to call it essence. I'm gonna try to change. They say you can't teach an old dog new tricks. Have faith in chaos. So I'm gonna try to not be an old dog. Basically, every zombie kill that isn't a headshot or a melee kill is 90 points. Whereas in the older games, it was 60, 70, 50. It depended where you shot them. And it was 100 for a headshot. Here, it's 115 for a headshot. In Cold War, it was also 115 for a melee. In this game, it's only 105, which I think is an improvement. I think it incentivizes headshots more than it does melee kills. And they did make it easier to get melee kills with that melee macchiato. I don't know if it's always a one hit or not. But it looks like it's going to be a little challenging to rack up these points. I did not do that right. There we go. You gotta be deliberate, like I said. Alright, let's not be pushy here. I almost have enough points. I should be able to have enough by the time I get to Pack Punch.
Guess that's one lockdown and 8 more to go.
What is it, a cat or something? Or is she just associating them with zombies? What the fuck is this? Oh, zipline. Cool. I don't know if I'm gonna get a max ammo, but I'll try.
Right in the gob.
I love that you can just hop over this way. Please buy it. Holy fucking shit. Moon moose protection. I hope so. I'm gonna need a protecting. It's doing damage. God damn, that thing's aggressive. So yeah, another reason I'm listing it that way is because, like, in the future, I would like to play at its fullest potential. And I feel like without playing on a 4K monitor, I can't reach the fullest potential of Brittany or my Series X. So although I'm getting a taste of it now, I would like to get the real experience later when it's time, when it's appropriate. But I'm glad that I get the opportunity to bend the rules a little bit. I have that ability, and hopefully I can make it until that point. But yeah, it's a big thing is you have to live your life in order to get to all those things. But it was honestly a goal of mine to have sex. I was like, I do not want to die without having sex. And I honestly don't think that's that unpopular of a thing to believe, maybe. But what do I know? I think that's one of my temptations. Like, I'm sure I've never been tempted to, like, steal, but I have been tempted to, like, have sex. So, like, I know how to restrain myself now. Like, I'm pretty good about, like, restrain myself in the sense that I don't need to, like, spend my weekends, like, seeking it out or, like, talking to people that, and, like, because I think a lot of people at a younger age say they're looking for love, but they're really just looking for sex. And that's why I think it's really interesting that there's that phrase, like, making love, and that directly translates to having sex. I need that. But I really think that sex is not always a loving act, and I'm sure, I don't know, I think sex can also be, like, when you become dependent on it, as if it is, like, a drug, like alcohol, or I don't know, whatever drug other than that, because I don't necessarily consider alcohol to be a drug, but I think it's similar. What the fuck? That's interesting. But when you become dependent on it, you accept sometimes abusive relationships, and sometimes, like, I don't know, abusive relationships in a lot of ways. Like, it doesn't just have to be, like, physical. It could be verbal. It could also be financial. I think sometimes we accept that because we don't want to, like, lose that. We think we can't live without it. And once you understand that you can live without a certain thing, like alcohol or drugs or even sex, you can try to spend your time in other ways. And you might be critiqued or criticized for doing things like that, spending your time in other aspects, but you only get one life if you think. Like, maybe we don't, maybe, I don't know, I'm not gonna pretend to know everything, like, really. I do go by the book. I find that following the biblical teachings has helped me in life, like, be more fulfilled and honestly happier, even though, like, it sometimes teaches, like, suffering for, like, the good of humanity, I guess. In my suffering, like, I'm happy. Like, I'm happy in my suffering. And yeah, sometimes that is like living without sex. Like, that can be difficult, but there's ways to wait, and there's ways to endure while you hopefully get to that point. And if it never happens, like, that's something I gotta live my life anyway. But to chase those experiences when it's not gonna be as good as it could be, I realize, like, then there's no need to have faith. I think it's good to have faith and to have hope, and it gives you reason to be happy and excited and live, really. I know these are pretty advanced things to talk about, but these are things that I want to be able to address on my channel, so if you enjoy that, like, cool, I'm happy to have you, and if not, well, like, that's okay. Glad you stopped by. But I think... Bingo. There's a lot to enjoy in this world, in this life, and there's only a limited time to do it, so... Mate, let's see if this costs money. No, it doesn't. Fuck yeah. Am I gonna be able to get on the roof? Oh, cool. Maybe this isn't open yet. Wow. Maybe this is where I started the game. Yeah, this is the spawn point. It's cool that that's open. I probably shouldn't be spending my money like that, though, because I could use some more perks.
Let me tell you how that thing works, but it works.
Well, hopefully it doesn't work on me. I'm getting points for this? Fuck yeah. That is oh shit. That is awesome. I need more armor, preferably. Yeah, so these manglers show up in Gorod Krovi, and I'm like, it's pretty... let me see if I can... 1,000, that's not so bad. I have enough for that. Cool. They do give you fighting chances in this game, which is cool. Like, it's not like you just run out of ammo, which, admittedly, like, I kind of thought it was fun to run out of ammo, but the cool thing is I can always go back to those games. Like, if you, like, buy a game, it's not, like, via Game Pass or something, you can always go back and play it as long as you have a console that can run it. So, I'm glad they made the Series X so prioritized. Fuck, dude, die. Holy shit. I gotta upgrade the rarity on this thing. I have enough for that. I just need to find a fucking station for it. As long as you have a console that can run, you can always revisit it. You just might not be able to play multiplayer or online because people just aren't on it or the servers aren't being maintained. But solo, you can play them, which is really awesome. It's really cool. That's why I think it is good to embrace solo gaming. Like, you might be lonely at times and you might be like, wow, I'm such a loser, I'm playing video games by myself. But like, why don't you say that when you're watching TV by yourself? Or maybe you do. Maybe you say, like, why am I reading a book by myself? But like, when you can be happy with yourself, and that takes time, like, don't get me wrong, go through all the toxic friend groups that you want or like bad things and like experience that, like, yo, when you can enjoy your own company, like, that's pretty lit. It's pretty lit. So I've always liked playing games solo, but I didn't do it that often. Yeah. Now I purposely make time for it, but it's also because I have more time. Like, when I was in college, it was much more difficult to do such a thing. But now that I'm not, it is a little easier. Other priorities arise here and there. And now that I want to make videos, like, I have to, like, edit. But I try to make time to, like, game without recording. Even if it's, like, training for a future video, like, it's still fun to play by myself without the pressure of the camera, which I don't mind having and experiencing. That's, like, kind of my like, issue with the Yankees right now is I think they're crumbling under the spotlight. Like, I know being a Yankee has a lot of pressure on it. Like, it's not like basketball where the Celtics and the Lakers are so close to each other. In baseball, like, the Yankees are, like, way ahead in terms of World Series. It's a lot of pressure to put that on, so I get it. But I'm really hoping they can win these three at home. By the time this goes up, those three at home will happen. The World Series could be over, but if they can win these three at home and then win one of two on the road... Special zombie, it's not an elite. Oh, hells yeah.
Oh, you are fucked now, shit for brain.
Let's see if I can use this thing.
Equinoda calling for a chopper gun.
There's music, you gotta be kidding me. Aw, it's like a multiplayer where you can only aim at certain areas. There I am. Oh, that was cool. Nifty. Ended the round, too. Waited until I got out to end the round. Can I climb through here, or is it just open for no reason? This is probably a spawn point, honestly. Yeah, I got, like, no dough. That's the thing. It's so much harder to make. I don't know if it's so... I think it is more difficult to get essence because you're not... I think I should get a max ammo at the end of this.
Tear them to
let me see if I can...
pieces.
Let me use this to try to find, I can ping this. That's awesome. Shit. There's gotta be a way I can find this upgrade, this stuff.
That hurt? Good.
Holy shit. Alright, let's just see if I can find it on the way, because I can't right now. Do I... What is this? It's active still. I haven't gotten one yet. That's ridiculous. They're holding out on me.
Sick. Look who's keeping up with you, geezers.
Yeah, yeah. Hopefully in the future I can play this with my friends. But like I said, since I want to play this game. But my friends are a little less like... I've always been the one who likes to play zombies the most. So, like, I do have friends that like playing zombies, and they play zombies, like, with me regularly. But, like, I think I like playing it the most. So, like, if I want to play it, I gotta make time for it. And I gotta play it by myself sometimes. So, hopefully by the time I can eventually get a monitor, which I don't think should be for quite some time. But my goal is hopefully by 2027. Hopefully they'll... hop along with me and like play some of these games with me. It is fun to play with your friends, but you usually do have to play more of the current games depending on if they have them or not, because more people have the current stuff. And I realize that's okay. Like, times change, things become new. Let me see how much it costs to upgrade this to legendary. 5,000. Holy crap. I don't have anywhere near that. Something that is cool about that, though, is that, like, if I hadn't bought that self-revive, I would probably be a lot closer to getting the legendary weapon. So, like, it's not... It was just so easy to get so many self-revives in Cold War, and now there's a limit. But there's still one extra, I think. Let's see how much it is for this one.
Max ammo.
And I might be able to even get a ammo mod. I only have enough for one, so... I'll wait to think about that, especially because it does look like there's no elemental pop. I can shoot while I'm here, that's crazy. Yeah, there's no elemental pop on this map, I wonder why. I could also try out the melee macchiato, but I just don't know if it's worth it. Especially because I should start saving for a double pack, because my guns would do a lot more damage if that was the case. I like some of those spawn points. They come out from under the buildings.
Alright, time for these stuff bounce to rack off.
Lethality.
Kaboom!
Nah, I really do like this combat axe a lot. Wow, I got a lot of points for that. I killed a whole horde with that. I guess it was... I'm getting points. I just don't have armor. Oh, there's one on each side, shit. Yeah, but the points thing does make shotguns a lot more viable, and snipers as well, to be fair. Whereas in the older games, it was like, you had to use an automatic weapon or you were going to not have a lot of money. Now it's purely based on kills. Let me see how many I have. 734, very nice. Yeah, I'm not sure why. I thought it was because of the monitor, and it really might be that, like, the Xbox wants to go faster than I'm letting it go. But, I don't know. So yeah, I might refer to her as a her. I might refer to it as an it. Like I said about the soul, like, I kind of give it the soul. It's something I've done for a long time with a lot of my devices. And, I don't know, maybe it could be a way that I try to feel a little less lonely in this lonely, lonely world, but... There's I don't know. You spend a lot of time by yourself, so. I wouldn't really say I feel all that lonely anymore. I used to be really afraid of loneliness. I thought it was all, like, deep, but I used to say my biggest fear was being alone. And, like, I don't know. I think maybe a lot of people feel that way too sometimes, but. I don't know. It's not. You're no. I don't know. You're never really alone, you know? You're, like, there's always someone around in there and like that you can find and look at and look to or whatever, but you also have to question like what might be pushing people away and if the people that you're pushing away are even people you would want to be with, because like it's also like where people like lose themselves in order to not be alone, and that I sometimes think is a little more sad than just being alone for a small amount of time. But I don't know. I think lying to yourself is one of the worst people you can lie to. That's so cool. I just noticed this pause timer. It doesn't start from the beginning. It like really does. If you're like really getting that tired, they want you to save and quit. Like they don't. They incorporate breaks. Like that's like something a lot of these games are doing. Because video games can be pretty exhausting things. Like they can be like, you're moving your hands a lot. You're focusing your brain, your eyes and stuff. Like you should try to not do it all like for such extensive periods of time. And sometimes these games really allow you to do that. So I think it's cool that they're proactive against that. This is a really good game. I'm really happy with it. And I do think I will be playing multiplayer in between that time, but probably not on this monitor. I think I need a lot more time to get used to the multiplayer and like have those experiences and like learn what modes I like the most. And also just like see like what guns I like and what I can even say, like, you know. And also gives me time to watch the penguin. It's cool. What is this? Holy crap. Project Janus. Shit. Yeah, so this is tough. They can't ride it after me, can they? So glad I have Jug. It's a good thing there's only a couple of entrances here, but nope, there's another entrance there. And there's spawn points as well. That was a blast. Let's see what I can do with this. This is a tight area. I think I can hop up this, though. Very nice. Yeah, it doesn't seem like this map is that story-driven like the other one was. I mean, I guess... Nah, like... I kind of want to die, like, not like die for real, like, or even in this game, but like, I feel like I am running out of things that I would like to talk about, and the exfil is coming up, but like, I would rather go down, but I feel like it is a little cheaper to just leave. So what I'm going to do instead is I'm going to purchase ammo mods with my salvage so that I can't buy another self-revive. And I think I'm going to get a napalm burst for this shoddy. Let's see if I can find my way and buy some perks now. Jug, 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 juggernog. Where are you, juggernog? Holy crap, they don't die anymore. Fuck. Yeah, this is like the trades that you gotta make. Fuck, I can't just buy it on the fly. They like really want you to hold X. At least I'll learn for this one. If I can somehow manage to get enough points to...
Shrimps on the barbie gets a fucking knife in their leg.
I might want to hit box and see if I can get a legendary rarity gun. See if I can survive in here, really. They have not given me anything. Nah, that's not good enough. Can I buy anything here? Probably not. Even if I wanted to, I think I'm better off getting an ammo mod for my other gun. That's cool, because you have to make choice about how much you invest. Oh shit, I looked down. That's dangerous. That was a bad toss. I could have picked up that plate. This is good. This is good. I'm liking this. I could buy armor. I just think I'm gonna lose it is the only reason I'm not sure I wanna spend half of my money on it.
Dad would have been proud of that one.
Yeah, now she's getting a little more deep with it. This is ridiculous. I think I may have made a mistake. by the fucking...
I don't care if it shoots fucking acorns. So long as the job gets done.
Wow, that is garbage. Compared, like, well, at least right now it is. I can pick up that Semtex, though. That is not garbage. Let's kill this guy first.
Fucking sticky!
Ah, double points. Perfect. And armor plates. Even better.
Double points.
I love the stamina music.
That makes this look easy. But it's not. It's not at all. I hate it. I just want a beer.
Exfil window is opening.
That was cool. I love when they say that's true. I saw that recently when I was watching basketball. I forget who they said. It was like, someone did something like super difficult and one of the commentators was like, they make it look so easy. And then I forget who it was and I feel so bad that I still haven't looked up his name. It was a teammate of LeBron's for a while, but I can't remember his name. It'll probably come back to me at some point, but I just can't remember his name. But he said, no, that's difficult. I might have, I don't know who it was. I don't know. I would rather not give wrong information, even if it's like a guess that could be right. If it's wrong, like I would feel bad. So I'm not gonna say it at all, but it was definitely one of LeBron's old teammates who happens to be a commentator now. So yeah, let's see if I can double pack a punch.
Can't be hungry if you don't have a head.
I think I'm gonna pack a punch the Munmu's protection because it has less ammo and it has an ammo mod on it currently.
Looks like I found the prize at the bottom of the cereal box.
Fair enough. Yeah, she's definitely the most youthful as well. Oh my god, I packed much the wrong gun. Whatever. I guess that means I should put an ammo mod on this one. I'm gonna put Deadwire on it. Fuck. Fuck. That was not great. Because now there's more options. Maybe I should get Cryo Freeze. I don't know. It depends. I'm playing this game on the iPhone called Castles right now. It's on Android and everything and probably like consoles too, but it's just like the continuation, like it's still Bethesda. They probably learned a lot from Fallout Shelter and then they, based on what they learned there, like made a really good fucking game. I really am like enjoying it a lot, but I'm curious. No, but like, so in Skyrim, well, Elder Scrolls, because that's where the world is based on, there's three different types of magic you can, there's three different types of destructive magic you can use. There's frost, flame, and shock. And the way they, like, you, I don't know if it matters that. I think it does matter your race or something, what you're skilled at most. But in the game, it's your personality. So, like, if you're heartless, you're better with frost. If you're volatile, you're better with shock. And if you're a pyromaniac, you're better with flame. So, Pyro, I don't even know, like, they don't explain it that much, just they like setting fire and stuff, but, like, volatile? Oh shit, they said, like, either fueled by their- no, it's like... Fuck it. I like it because, the volatile was, like, they're fueled by anger. So, like, if they're angry, they play better. Which, I always found that, like, some players, like, I don't think play as well. And I'll name the two. I really don't think Westbrook plays all that much better when he's angry. When he's driven and he's, like, serious, like, he plays better. Trey, on the other hand, when he's mad, he starts to freaking cook. So, like, you're not- he's, like, the type of person you don't want to poke the bear. But Heartless, like, damn, that's, like, tough. Heartless was interesting that you'd be powerful with Frost, and like, that's where like, I get into this role-playing aspect where like, does Maya seem Heartless? Like, not really, so like, I don't know. Oh shit. But I'm doing alright, we'll see how this goes. I'm building on my points again, which I'm liking. I just realized I have C4, and this equipment does a lot of damage, so that's why it's so valuable.
C4 out. Found that a bit too satisfying.
It's okay. Me too. Oh, fuck. I might go down if I get hit again. Well, I got hit again, but I had armor. That's good. I would love to buy that speed cola now that I can. We'll see.
Ahead. We got low flying corpses.
See if I can buy speed cola. I think I almost got stuck. everything. My Xbox is spazzing out. It's like roller.
Anyone packing marshmallows? Huh, too soon?
Can't tell you how much I love that popping sound.
I want to kill that fucking elite. Ow! Oh, shit. Honestly, this is kind of a good thing, because I think it's going to be cheap. Well, I did. I'm pretty sure I wanted to pack punch it because it didn't have a lot of ammo. Alright, fuck it. I'm buying this armor this time. What I want to do is I want to buy ammo, but I think it only costs me 1,000, and I can get that. They don't want to die. We get armor, but so do they. And I don't have enough right now. Fuck. 2,500 if it's double packed, 1,000 if it's single packed. I wonder how wonder weapons are. I don't think it's the same. Holy crap. Shit. I need points. I need kills.
I prefer slow roasted, but this works too.
Fuck, I tried to get a look at that and I almost died. It's free points, so I don't need it. I don't need it. I'm not gonna get greedy. I don't need it. I gotta get myself some more ammo in this shotty. See how long this goes for me. Let's see how much salvage I got. I could probably buy some. Well, I'm dead.
And I thought my life was going up in flames.
Oh my god, fucking die, please. Oh shit. Ask and you shall receive, I guess. Fuck. Oof. Not quite.
Don't suppose Uncle Sam gives out medals for marksmanship.
Okay, I'm broke as fuck. I think it would be in my best interest to get some equipment with this salvage, but it looks like there's only very few places where it is, which is kind of annoying, but also reasonable. Yeah, I'm taking heavy hits. I think every hit is like 50, and I think I had armor. Yeah, this is bad. This looks like not great. That wall gun is probably so expensive because the wall gun's up in rarity as the rounds go on, but they also get more pricey. And I do not seem to be overflooding with monies. That bonus points right here would be much welcomed. But let's see if I can find a way to get that equipment station now through Liberty Lanes. I don't know what I want. I don't even know what I have unlocked. I might not have anything unlocked. Let's see. But it's cool that you unlock things as you go. So yeah, I got Semtex. Let's see what some Semtex. Fuck. Yeah, I definitely liked that. I like those types of, I like that death scene a lot. I like games with good death scenes. Last of Us Part 2, shout out. I think Last of Us Part 1 probably has the 2, but I haven't played that game in a while, so. I had a lot. That was all overall salvage. Is that really overall salvage, or how much I had? Nah, I think it was overall salvage. Yeah, let's see how much I level up. That was a pretty good round, so. Very cool. I got a good amount of stuff. I got some operators. I got some Yeah, probably better. Don't even say that. Yeah, but there's some wonder weapons and stuff. That's cool. But what I wanted to show was this barracks, I guess, the progression. So, not the level unlocks necessarily. I wanted to. Where? How do I show? Not operators. Loadouts. Barracks. It's got to be in barracks. Customized, I think it is. Energy mine, huh? I got a mastery badge. That's cool. I don't think you unlock these necessarily, but. The calling cards you do unlock, so this was the one I wanted to show, the gladiator, because it had the Samantha running with her teddy bear, or at least the sword of Samantha, so that was cool, but didn't want me to select it, apparently. This one was the one that I used when I got that one, but look at all the ones that I unlocked, Rip and Tear, huh? Wolf of Metals, I did cop that one, admittedly. That's the where you go with that, huh? Crimson, Make History, I don't have any multiplayer ones. Some of these look interesting, though. What the fuck? Busted. Switchblade, Perks of the Jobmaster. Let's go. Yeah, I got some zombies ones, but I got some to go. But that's cool. But like, that's crazy. They want you, like, why are they showing me ones that take all the way until Prestige 7 to get? So, yeah, I probably won't play the campaign for a good amount of time. If I do, I'm like not that interested in it right now, and I have other things that I want to do. But yeah, I guess I showed that, and I ain't really got too much to say, but it is pretty nice to hear. There's some emotes and sprays and a loading screen, but. Won't worry about that. If you want to get this game and everything, like, I encourage it. Enjoy, like, if you can afford it. It's not going to take up too much of your time. But yeah, this is the zombie intel I was talking about that you can find some. So I guess we'll find the one, listen to the one, and then we'll call it the standalone.
This is Dr. Annette Pelletier. We couldn't contain the breach, and the LTG's been blown to bits. The bank vault is going to be the smartest place to wait this out. If I don't suffocate before I'm rescued, Moline and Panos' comms are dead. I'm betting they are too. I knew this day was coming. It was foolish to think we had more time. It started as whispers, these idiotic claims that Janus leadership was holding someone captive. But it didn't stop there. Other, more deranged gossip suggested the victim was being held in some sort of tank. I wrote it off. We were all overworked and some people were starting to crack. Less than a week later, an anti-fraternization policy was enforced. We weren't allowed to interact with other departments. Research teams are kept compartmentalized. It's essential to our work, but with Janus, was that also to cover up something nefarious? All I know is the conspiracies flying around suddenly had an air of legitimacy, and if even a fraction of it was true, everyone was in danger. I warned my team about the rumors. Fingers crossed they're still alive. Security was a different story. They chose to ignore the bossy lady scientist. Whatever. I may be bossy, but those negligent a-holes have killed us all.
Sheesh. Yeah, bossy's another one of the personality traits, and it's like it helps other people be more productive, but everyone's unhappy if they work with them, so that's kind of funny. That kind of reminds me of the Shangri-La Easter egg a little bit, just a little bit. And also I was like thinking about how like Gorod Krovi was kind of like Shangri-La as well, because it's really difficult, but it's also, now that I'm getting used to it, I'm really liking it. It might be one of my favorite maps, just like Shangri-La was. But I think for this one I'm gonna have to prefer Terminus, I gotta say that. So we'll see how the rest of these maps go. We'll see what I look up and everything, but I got plenty on my plate right now. So hope you're living life any way you can. I know it's probably a challenging time, a lot of change and different stuff, but close out 2024 the only way you know how. Okay, and welcome change. Anyway, that's been Tog. Hope you enjoy your night, evening, morning, whatever it is that you're doing. Stay awesome and peace out.